Hello, welcome to today's story. Today is Friday, December 22nd, 2023. My story is going to be taken from Wednesday, the 20th of December. I had a few errands to do, a little bit of grocery shopping, and I needed to get a couple of things done. And one of the things was to get a couple of decorations for New Year's Eve paper plates. Sounds easy. Okay, so I go to first I go to the dollar store. Sold out. Go to Walmart. I can't see anything. I stop a manager. They say, oh, it's too soon. We don't put out New Year's Eve things until Christmas. And I'm thinking, really? Because the day after Christmas, you'll be taking down the Christmas stuff. You'll be putting out Valentine's candy. I don't understand why you don't have New Year's Eve out. This is all in my head. Okay, I go to Target. I walk into Target, and the first person I see is the employee, the security guard, wired up, checking everything. Okay, paper plates that only say New Year. New Year, like, it was just too much to fit the word happy on there. Or gonna be happy. You didn't want to commit to the word happy. That's too much of a promise. You didn't want to break. What's wrong with saying the word happy? Is happy in violation of something? It didn't fit on the plate. You can go with smaller font. I don't understand. Are we eliminating the word happy? No more happy birthday. Everything will just be birthday. No more happy anything. I don't understand what's wrong with, why doesn't the plate just say on it happy and get rid of the word New Year? I would rather have happy than the word New Year. What are we going to put out for party favors? Little decorations, little jars of Vaseline. I hope next year's better than this one so you don't need this. Dun! Happy. Huh. Okay. So I'm not getting anywhere on this little decoration thing, you know? I go to the grocery store, and they have something that I like. They have mussels, and they're from Canada. And I go, oh, great. But I look, they were trying to make sure they're going to be okay. But lady, they're dead. No, mussels are alive. No, they're dead. Listen, I can't find plates that say the Happy New Year, but you're not going to tell me, this is all going on in my head, you're not going to tell me that I'm buying dead mussels. So the guy is looking at me, he goes, do you see any water tanks here? Do you see live fish? No, I don't. Well, that's right. And the mussels are dead. Okay, because this is all good. I can make my decision about the mussels. I can figure out other things to do for New Year's Eve. On the face of the earth, of all the things that could be going on, this is a tiny little nothing. It's minute, picayune nothing. Or as my dear friends who had Sicilian family, their father would say to me, Spatch. Anyway, Spatch. The father of the family would sit in the car with his best friend and they would read the racing paper daily and figure out the races, what they might spend a few dollars on. So one day, I know about 3 years at this point, I worked for them. I was in high school. I worked for them in college. Nice older guys. They just mind their own business and talk to me a little bit. And they call me Toots. I walk over and they go, sometimes they wanted me to get them a soda or just bring them something. I go, yeah, what? And they go, pick a number for a horse. And I said, I don't know anything about horse racing. I don't know anything about horses. I can't pick a number. Just pick a number. And I can't. So the old man, the father, smacks his friend on the shoulder and says, Spatch, can you believe? Toots can't pick a number. And he goes, eh. And I go, so by the way, why do you call him Spatch? And what's that mean? Well, they wouldn't tell me when I first started working there. I guess I was a little too young. But now years have passed, whatever. And they go, well, in their translation, it means you are no more important or this thing or what you're talking about or you is no more important on the face of the earth than a mere speck of sperm, which is pretty insignificant, tiny. So, now on the other hand, that one little sperm can lead into something, to a person that could cause a lot of something. But at the moment, I have to put things into perspective, don't I? The little problems of paper plates and mussels are nuggets of nothing, nothing in the face of the world of what's going on. I keep myself calm and relaxed and just say to myself, Sfacim, it's all good. I am going to have a good time, whether with or without paper plates, with or without the mussels. It's all good. These are just things. It's just how you look at it. That's my story, and I'm sticking with it. You have a good day, and this is Toots.